Welcome back friends. Today we are going to study about the gyroscope. What is the gyroscope? The gyroscope is a mechanical system or arrangement having a rotor spinning at high speed about its axis and being free to turn in any direction. The gyroscope having only a one axis stabilization which has a balance from all the eight directions and moving towards the momentum, right? Whenever a body is rotating in a plane about an axis and a couple is applied on the rotating body across the axis of rotation or spin in another perpendicular plane, the rotating or spinning body starts processing in a third mutually perpendicular plane, right? When body is rotating in a one plane, suppose this is the axis of gyroscoping couple, or you can say if the body is rotating in a plane X, right, or plane Y Z, so the couple is applied on the rotating body across the axis of rotation or spin in another perpendicular plane, right? So the axis of gyroscoping couple is this, which is perpendicular to the axis of rotating, and also the spin of the rotating body is another plane, right, which is perpendicular to the body. Now three axes is given in this diagram. One is the axis of rotation or axis of the spin, axis of gyroscopic couple, and axis of precession, right? So the three plane which is taken as the plane, all plane are taken as the perpendicular of the axis. If the axis of rotation is x, then the axis plane of the rotation is perpendicular to the x, same as the plane of the precession and plane of the gyroscoping couple are perpendicular to the plane of axis of precession and axis of gyroscoping couple respectively. The computer applications where the gyroscope is used is computer pointing devices. Gyroscopic behavior is used in the racing car industry. This is because car engine act just like a big gyroscope. Wheels on motorbike acts as gyroscope and makes the bike easier to balance when moving. Ship stabilizers also use the gyroscope. Precessional angular motion. We know that the angular acceleration is the rate of change of angular velocity with respect to time. When the angular velocity will be changed with respect to time, then the angular acceleration will be occur. Same as the vector quantity, precession angular motion is the vector quantity. Why? Because if it change the direction, is also called as the change in velocity. So the vector quantity and may be represented by drawing a vector diagram with the help of right hand screw rule, right? The right hand screw rule is the rule which shows the all three axes, like the axis of spin, axis of gyroscopic couple, and axis of precession, right? So the axis of spin, which is the x axis, where the axis of gyroscopic couple and axis of precession, all three axes can be evaluated with the help of right hand screw rule, right? Suppose you are taking a disc which is moving along the x axis. So axis of spin is the x axis, right? Balancing is not there, or the gyroscope is not there, then what happens? Then the body which is moving is change its place or change the angle, is called as delta theta, and makes a new axis of spin which is x dash. So the angular velocity will also change, and it's called as w omega plus delta omega, right? So the acceleration can be occurred due to the change in velocity, due to the change in the direction of the rotating body, right? So this is the vector quantity. So we can generate the vector of x, vector of x dash, and change in velocity. Change in velocity is r x dash, or you can say the x x dash is omega plus delta omega minus omega. So x x dash vector is known, is evaluated as the change in velocity. Now, after a short interval of time, the disk be spinning about the new axis of spin OX dash with the angular velocity of omega plus delta omega. Using the right hand screw rule, initial angular velocity of the disk omega is represented by vector OX and the final angular velocity of the disk omega plus delta omega is represented by O dash, right? Similar as discussed in the the OX is the initial angular motion, angular velocity, and OX dash is the final angular velocity, right? So the vector XX dash, which represents the change in angular velocity in time delta t, the angular acceleration of the disk, right? So this may be resolved in two components, one parallel to OX, one parallel to OX, and other is perpendicular to OX dash, right? So the component of the angular velocity in direction of OX, alpha t, is xr divided by delta t is equal to or minus OX, right? Which is xr is equal to or minus OX divided by delta t, which is OX dash cos delta theta minus OX, right? So XR is equal to omega plus delta omega minus omega plus delta omega into cos delta theta minus omega. So we can get the omega cos delta theta plus omega delta theta minus omega, right? So delta theta is very small quantity. Therefore, substituting the cos delta theta is equal to 1, we have alpha t is equal to omega plus delta omega minus omega is equal to delta omega by delta t is the acceleration, tangential component of the acceleration, and radial component of the acceleration is rx dash. Radial component of the acceleration is rx dash, which can be evaluated with the help of ox dash sine omega plus delta omega divided by delta t, right? In the time where delta t tends to zero, we can get the tangential component of the acceleration can be limit delta t tends to zero delta omega divided by delta t. So we can get the d omega divided by dt, right? Now the angular acceleration in the direction of perpendicular to OX, which is called as radial component of the acceleration, alpha c is equal to rx dash divided by delta t. As discussed, the rx dash is the radial component of the acceleration of omega, right? So the rx dash is equal to ox dash, rx dash is equal to ox dash sine delta t, which is OX dash is omega plus delta omega into sine delta t delta theta divided by delta t, right? So omega delta theta plus delta omega into sine delta theta divided by delta t. Since the delta theta is very small quantity, so therefore substituting the value sine delta theta is equal to delta theta, right? So we have the value of alpha c is equal to omega into delta theta plus delta omega into delta theta divided by delta t, right? Here delta omega and delta theta both value is very small, and if we multiply the two small value, we can generate another less value. So we can neglect the delta omega into delta theta with respect omega into delta theta. So we can get the value omega into delta theta divided by delta t. Now if we limit the time tends to zero, we can get the alpha c, the Coriolis component of the acceleration, or you can say the radial component of the acceleration, alpha c is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 is equal into omega delta theta divided by delta t, which tends omega delta theta by delta t. Delta theta divided by delta t is the omega p, right? So the angular velocity of, or you can say the angular velocity of the particle, so total angular acceleration of the disk is equal to vector x x dash, which is equal to the vector sum of alpha t plus alpha c, right? Means the tangential component of the acceleration and Coriolis equation, Coriolis acceleration of the Coriolis component of the acceleration. So the vector xx dash denotes that the summation of the two component, tangential component and Coriolis component, is equal to d omega divided by dt plus omega into d theta by dt equal to d omega divided by dt plus omega into omega p, where d theta by dt is the angular velocity of the axis of spin about a certain axis, which is perpendicular to the axis of, which is perpendicular to the axis of gyro, to the plane in which the axis of spin is going to rotate. Now here the diagram is shown as the axis of spin, new axis of spin, and the vector diagram, where the d theta by dt is the angular velocity of the axis of spin about a certain axis, which is perpendicular to the plane and which the axis of spin is going to rotate, right? This angular velocity of the axis of spin is known as the angular velocity of precession, right? So d theta by dt is known as angular velocity of precession, which is a change in angle with respect to time. Means if the value of d theta by dt is very less, then you can say the precision of the gyroscopic motion or precision of the movement of the disk is very accurate, right? The axis about which the axis of spin is to turn is known as the axis of precision. The angular motion of the axis of spin about the axis of precision is known as the precisional angular motion, right? So three important notes are there to be remember about the gyroscopic couple for the precision angular motion. Is the axis of precision is perpendicular to the plane in which the axis of spin is going to rotate, right? If the angular velocity of the disk remains constant at all position of the axis of spin, then d theta by dt is zero, right? Means if the motion of the disk is very accurate and it stands to zero, right? If the change of the angle or change of the position of the disk is tends to zero, means the position is constant, it's not change its position with respect to time, then d theta by dt is zero. Thus the Coriolis component of the acceleration remains zero. If the angular velocity of the disk changes the direction but remains the constant in magnitude, then the angular acceleration of the disk is given by alpha c is equal to omega into d theta by dt, where d theta by dt is given by angular velocity of precision, so omega into omega p. The angular acceleration omega c is known as gyroscopic acceleration, right? So the Coriolis component, which is known as Coriolis component of the angular acceleration, which is known as the gyroscopic acceleration, right? Or we can see that the change of the motion, or you can say the change in place due to the motion, is known as the acceleration or angular acceleration or Coriolis component of the acceleration, which is known as the gyroscopic acceleration. Next is the gyroscopic couple. When the gyroscopic speed, or when the disk is moving or spinning at its position, and if it is changed the position and gyroscopic effect is produced or gyroscopic acceleration is generated, then two component of the velocity will be produced. and the gyroscopic couple will be produced. So now let's learn how the gyroscopic couple to be precise. Consider a disc spinning with an angular velocity omega radian per second about the axis of spin OX in anticlockwise direction when seen from the front, right? If we are seeing the disc which is moved towards the axis or about the axis, right, from the x-axis, then the speed or angular velocity of the disc is omega and its spin about the OX, right? Since the plane which is disc is rotating is parallel to the plane YOZ, the plane YOZ, right, is known as the plane of spinning, right? the plane XOZ, which is perpendicular to this plane of spinning and having the axis of spin rotates, is known as the plane of precession, right? So the plane of precession is OXZ. The plane of precession is XOZ. So the change in motion or change in the angle is in this plane, right? XOZ. So the gyroscopic acceleration which can be generated or which will be generated is in this plane, right? In other words, the axis of spin is said to be rotating or processing about an axis OY. In other words, the axis of spin is said to be rotating about the axis of OY at an angular velocity of omega p radian per second, right? The horizontal plane XOZ is called as the plane of precession and OY is the axis of precession, right? The next is the change in angular moment. Change in angular momentum. Let I is equal to mass moment of inertia of the disc about OX. Omega is the angular velocity of the disc. So the angular momentum of the disc, which is known as I into omega. Since the angular momentum is the vector quantity, therefore it may be represented by the vector OX as shown in figure, right? So OX is known as angular momentum vector quantity, and where if it's change its position or it is change its direction, then if the Coriolis component of acceleration is generated, then X is change its place to X dash, and OX dash, which is known as precision, angular of precision, right? So the axis of spin OX is also rotating anticlockwise when seen from top about the axis of OY. Let the axis OX is turned in the plane XOZ through a small angle delta theta radian to the position of OX dash in time delta t second, assuming the angular velocity omega to be constant, right? The angular momentum will now be represented by the vector OX dash, right? So when the disc is moving about the X axis at very high speed, it will change its direction. It will change its direction, and the position of X is changed to X dash. OX, which is known as the angular momentum vector, now the angular moment of vector is represented by vector OX dash, right? So the change in angular momentum is OX dash minus OX. The difference between two vector OX dash minus OX. So the difference is XX dash, where the XX dash is OX dash cos delta theta, OX dash sine delta theta, where delta theta is very small quantity. So sine delta theta is taken as only delta theta. So the change in angular momentum is taken as OX into delta theta, right? So the OX is the I omega delta theta, right? OX is the I omega and delta theta is the change in angular momentum. And the rate of change of angular momentum is I omega into delta theta by delta t, right? So rate of change is the change of the angular momentum with respect to time. Since the rate of change of angular momentum will result by the application of couple to the disk, therefore the couple applied to the disk causing precession, right? Where C is taken as limit delta t tends to zero I omega into delta theta by delta t equal to I omega into delta d theta by dt, right? So we can take as I omega omega p, where omega p is the angular velocity of precession of the axis of spin or the speed of the rotation of this axis of spin about the axis of precession O y, right? So the change in angular momentum, or you can say the rate of change of angular momentum can be taken as capital C is equal to I omega into omega p. Effect of the gyroscopic couple on aeroplane, right? So the gyroscopic couple can be generated where the gyroscopic acceleration will be generated, right? In the aeroplane, the top and engine and the propeller rotates in clockwise direction, right? In the aeroplane, the engine and propeller both are rotating about the axis. Both are rotating about the axis, or you can say the clockwise direction when seen from the rear or tail end. And the aeroplane takes turn the left, right? How this will be possible if the propeller or engine rotates in clockwise direction from the rear, then it turns left, and if it rotates in anticlockwise direction, then it turns to right, right? This is the effect of gyroscopic couple, which can be said as swaying or hammering, right? We will be studying. Where omega, let us first study about the terminology which is used in the gyroscopic couple. Is omega equal to angular velocity of the engine, which is taken as radian per second, small m is equal to mass of the engine and the propeller in kg, k is equal to its radius of gyration in meters, I is equal to mass moment of inertia of the engine and the propeller in kg into meter square, v is equal to linear velocity of the aeroplane, capital R is the radius of curvature in the meter, and omega p is the angular velocity of precession. So the gyroscopic couple acting on the aeroplane, capital C, which is taken as I omega into omega p. Before taking the left turn, the angular moment vector is represented by Ox, right? Let us discuss how the aeroplane takes the left turn, right? When it takes the left turn, the active gyroscopic couple will change the direction of the angular moment of vector from Ox to Ox dash, right? The vector xx dash in the limit represents the change of angular momentum or the active gyroscopic couple and is perpendicular to the Ox, right? Thus the plane active gyroscopic couple xoy will be perpendicular to the xx dash vertical in this case, right? So if the angular precession or active gyroscopic couple vector will move the clockwise direction from the rear, right, which will be result the momentum will be higher at the right side. Means if the axis of the spin is x, and the propeller or engine rotates the clockwise direction from the rear side, then the momentum will be momentum is going to increase about the z axis. So the change of momentum will be balanced with the help of gyroscoping effect, and it takes turn left turn to balance the gyroscopic effect. By applying the right hand screw rule to the vector xx dash, we find that the direction of the active gyroscopic couple is clockwise, as shown in front view of figure, right? Suppose this is the x-axis, right? If we applying the rule of right hand thumb rule, right? If we apply the right hand thumb rule to xx dash, then we will find that the direction of the active gyroscoping couple is the clockwise direction, right? In other words, for the left hand turning, the active gyroscopic couple on the aeroplane is axis OZ will be clockwise. The reactive gyroscopic couple will act in the opposite direction to balance the momentum. And the effect of this couple is therefore to raise the nose and dip the tail of the aeroplane, and it will be take left turn. Right? Now the case 2, where the propeller rotates in clockwise direction when seen from the rear and aeroplane takes toward right. So second case we had already discussed about. The first case, which is if the engine or propeller rotates in clockwise direction when seen from the rear or tail and the aeroplane takes turn to the left, right? Now this is the second case, which is the propeller rotates in clockwise direction when seen from the rear end and aeroplane takes turns toward the right. Third case is the propeller rotates in anticlockwise direction when seen from the rear and aeroplane turns toward left. Similar, the fourth case is if the propeller rotates in anticlockwise direction when seen from the rear and aeroplane turns towards the left, right? All four cases, which will be discussed in our next lecture, right? So about the all cases, we have to study about, or we have to understood well about the momentum of the change in momentum or angular momentum which is produced due to the angular acceleration, right? And we have to study about the gyroscope and gyroscopic effect very well, right? So these four cases is important. So we will study about next lecture, right?